we are at the hottest spot in North America, and we stopped at the Rhyodite ghost town. Basically, just this place's complete ruins. Over here, if you can see, they said that's a school. It's pretty cool. We're on our way to our campsite, but this one we noticed wasn't too far out of the way. So, quick pit stop. Yeah, I'm trying to read these infographics to find out the history of this ghost town. I don't know, but I assume it has something to do with the gold rush, because it seems like a lot of things in this area brought in a lot of people because of gold. Alright, this is the last one we're going to take a look at before we move on. This, they say, was an old school. Too bad it's fenced off, but so Haley's seen like 5 lizards so far. Whoa!
What?
A bunch of huge desert ants. Yeah. But what I'm trying to say is I haven't seen a single lizard. Can you hold it here for a second? Yeah, I don't want to mess with these guys. Things are big, man.
Yeah, they're coming this way. They're
I don't want any of them to start crawling on me at all. We're kind of at the what I think might be the bottom of Death Valley, and it is like another world. I don't even know how to describe this. And the heat is so, so hot. In the direction that the wind's coming, it's almost too much to handle. ...20 minutes from our location. So almost feels like it's a beach up there, but no, it's just death. Alright, so this is where we're gonna camp for the night. Beautiful view. The car did great until we pulled in. Then a bunch of gauges went crazy. We'll let the car do some cooling down and then check it out.
Distance from the man that I am to the man I want to be. The time it takes to realize time is the distance I need. But I was born impatient, and I was born unkind. But I refuse to believe I have to be the same person I was born when I die. 'Cause change is alright. Change is alright.
It's 6:30 in the morning in Death Valley. Cool air that was here is just about gone as the sun's rising. We're taking all the stuff out of the trunk and reinstalling it a little in a little bit of a better way.
we're gonna try to get out of this area before the heat gets a little too strong. I'm as tired as an old goat.
We're back at this truck stop, and when we were at the campsite, Haley got a big old splinter underneath her fingernail, like right underneath. So we got a sewing kit, and she's gonna try to dig it out the best she can.
It really hurts.
You're making me nervous.
I don't even know how to get it out. It's so deep in there. Come on, get out. It's like coming off in chunks.
Doberman over there, Mabel's super excited about it. She's half Doberman. She's half Doberman, so that's probably why. Area 51, shut up. Area 51 Alien Center right here. Because of Mabel and because of the heat, we're taking turns. Haley's checking it out right now, and I'm going in a second. So yeah, you're right. Pretty much just a gas station with a few souvenirs.
Yeah.
But there is a brothel, an alien brothel right next door. So we're a little bit north of Las Vegas right now, probably still in Las Vegas city limits. Took a stop for some pee and to get Mabel some wet food. She's just being extra picky about eating her dry food somewhere. What's that? So we want to make sure she eats and drinks enough, so we're spoiling her. Yeah, this is the Petro Sinclair station. We don't have as much of a drive today as we did yesterday, but it's still pretty decent. I think we still have 4 hours. Maybe 5 remaining, and there's also a Dunkin' Donuts in this travel stop, which Haley seemed pretty excited about. She's in there right now. I assume she'll be bringing out some Dunkin' Donuts. What'd you get?
Plastic glaze.
Nice. Is it as good as you hoped and dreamt? Hoped and dreamed? Yeah. Got these postcards in Nevada near Area 51. Rode them the next day, hundreds of miles away, and now we're in Utah dropping them off.